They say music is the food of life, or food for the soul. And that gentleman you saw in the video has joined us in the studio, Awal, a talent that TVs we actually help in unearthing. Righty, yes.
Awal, you know him, right?
So many years ago, and now it's a big guy now. Awal, how are you?
I'm fine.
Great, you're doing fine.
Yeah.
Just complete your school.
Yeah.
How was school?
School was good, you know, everything was okay.
And the fame about being a TV3 talented kid and in school, and how was it feeling like?
It was cool in any way. Like, I felt nervous in school whenever I go to classroom. But with time, I was cool with it. And it was a boys' school too, so.
Oh, okay.
Why were you nervous?
Okay, wow. Seniors were worrying me. You know, a lot of you can't just walk around. You can't just walk around. You know, when you hey bra.
Oh.
You can't say minko because
you're junior.
Yeah, you're junior. Oh. Okay. So I got used to it. Form two.
Oh, okay.
When I got to form two, the seniors had left them and the
now you're a big
boys,
person around.
Boys are around. So.
I hope they didn't collect all your Gary and shit.
Oh, no.
They didn't do that?
No.
Okay. Because when we were in school, our seniors were collecting all our guidance.
I see. But why did you decide? Was it your parents, the education bits? Because, you know, when you come on Talented Kids, there's this danger of staying, you know, in the spotlight and moving on. But why did you decide? Was it your parents that forced you to go back to school and finish school?
Oh, you wanted to go back to school.
I wanted to go back to school. Because in this our business, this music business, when you don't go to school, you know, you are being lessed. I don't know how to put it. You are being underrated.
Okay.
But a lot of our guys, should I say, excuse my language, like some are not well
educated.
So
when
I dropped all my mics, my books and pen, rap.
Right. So that you could go back to school.
So
when you have a contract, you can read and understand.
Yeah, I can read and understand myself and sign myself.
And sign yourself.
See?
So that you don't find any money getting missing on the contract.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
I see. So let me take you back to school. So form two, now you stabilized in school. Now form three, this is Awal, the famous Awal TV3 talented kids champion. Form three, a senior.
Yeah.
What changed?
As I said earlier on, my rap, my music, the kind of like I gave music in form one, 60% was for books and 40 was for music. So
right.
I was still recording
way back in
school, but I got to form two to form three, like it decreased.
Okay.
And I used to, I had to give book 80% or 85 and use 15 for my music.
That's smart.
Yeah, so. By God's grace, I'm done now.
You're done.
But I will further my education.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. What's your ideal university? Oh, technical
University of Ghana.
University of Ghana.
Yeah.
Lego, you have an admission in advance.
Yeah.
We're getting
they
him there.
And any particular interest you have?
Yeah.
What course?
Performing.
Performing.
Oh, you want to do that?
Yeah,
I see.
Yeah.
I see. Great. So now you're out now. In the next few months ahead of you, it means that a lot of concentration will be on music.
Yeah, sure.
What are you doing now, as far as music is concerned?
I'm recording. I have a lot of music in my archives, like, so I'm bringing. I released my single, I think, last 2 months, which is
what we saw.
No, which is Gwagbuna. And I released this video yesterday.
Okay.
Oh, just yesterday?
Yeah, just yesterday.
The one on the screens now.
Yeah. Mm. And I'll be releasing another song next week with Iwan, my uncle, so watch out.
Is your uncle, like, for real?
Yeah, that's my mom's kid brother.
Oh, that's nice. Iwan, I like him.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. So how many songs have you recorded that's not yet released? How many?
A lot. I can't really tell you the number of songs I've recorded.
Is there a particular theme running through your music? Is there a particular idea, subjects that you want to put out that is running through your music? Do you rap about a particular thing or is diverse? You pick from everything.
I do something you can relate to. I have a lot of concepts, positive thinking. I do it all around. I have a gospel song with Nero X as well. Yeah, so hip hop, I do it all around, high life.
And you intend to stay like that? to stay all around, do everything, gospel?
I think music is all about sending the good and right message out there. So doing my own thing is, I'm doing it my own way.
You're doing your own way.
Yeah.
When you became TV3's most talented kid, did you follow the program after you became a champion?
Yeah.
You did?
I followed the season 1 and season 2 and season 3. Mm. And I had to go to school. Mm. So I couldn't follow up.
You lost the track.
Yeah.
But you're watching this one now.
I'm watching.
The final is on. But this is first me.
First
me. That's the final
first
one.
Me, yeah.
I'm sure you'll be there.
Sure. Yeah. Why not? I'm always welcome to my home.
Oh, of course.
That's great.
Please,
that's
take,
great.
Take
that's great to hear.
Just leave.
That's his home.
I
see.
I like the swag, though. Mm. But you know, one person that influenced you when you were on the show, Sack.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
How is that like? Did you keep in touch with him? What's the situation like, you know, with you and Sack Nation?
Thank you. We're still working, but you know, Sack is one person I can't let go of wherever I go.
Okay.
You know, I appreciate whatever he's been doing for me, you know, entertainment wise and like personal life.
What has he done for you?
He's nurtured me a lot about my music. You know, I'm still learning. He's teaching me a lot about this, you know, entertainment thing. So when I come, I know my left and right. I know what I'm about. So a big shout out to Sarkodie. God bless you.
Mm. Right. If you had to use one word to describe him, what would it be to describe Sarkodie? Find a word that will sum up how you feel about him.
I don't know. You know, Sarkodie, the new word be made to me that describe him. It's big.
You don't say money no be problem.
Money there no be problem. You say money no be problem.
I see. Great that you've been following the show, and like you said, the season currently running, you've been following it. What do you make of, particularly your area, the young ones who are singing, what do you make of them?
Yeah, I think they are doing good. One rapper is among them. Mm-hmm. I think that guy is the girl.
Right.
I think the girl is good, so, you know, she should keep it up. You know, we are all still learning, you know, bit by bit. I think we will get there, so we should keep it up.
Are you in touch with any of those who have been on the show and have left, or?
My season.
Oh, yes. And Tutula Pato, what do you make of him?
Tutula Pato is good. Yeah. And we link up most of the times in the studio at Nungwa, which is BMG.
Mm.
And he even stays at Nungwa. He schools at Nungwa, so. We keep in touch.
You think he should go back to school? Because one of the criticisms he received when he was on the show was that, you know, he's young, he's very talented, he raps well in tree, but they wanted him to go to school because they thought that he lacked a little bit. What's your own impression?
That's what it is, because it happened to me. I had to go back to school because I wowed 2010 to, and I went, I just
Six
went
years,
off
years, I can't believe
to,
it.
Till 2016 and it's, you know. So you need to go to school. Education is one thing you can live in your life. So
I see. Great. Great to know. Now, let me also pick this from you. The local music industry, for instance, TV3 is giving young ones like you the opportunity to unearth your skills, your talents. What do you think the young ones like you need in order to be able to blossom, to grow, to develop, to become great ones like Sack?
Great question.
Yeah, TV3 is doing good. And God bless TV3 for putting up such programs.
Mm.
You know, for me, even I took this TV3's platform to do a lot of things, many stuff. And it has helped me in many, many ways. And God bless TV3. So I would say leaders in our music and industry should try and put some youth programs together, some talent hunt for our boys to jump on and show what they can do and show what they have.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that one alone.
But the talent hunt, you know, has a period. Mm. It works for, say, 13 weeks. You'll be on TV. After that, what happens after is what is even more important, because you can have this much fame, you'll be at the height of it, and then you fizzle out, right? So how about mentorship?
do you think, because you mentioned a great example of Sakode, mentorship would help in sustaining the interest and expand more, you know, the interest of the kids who appear on such shows?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If such programs are being done and you get some good people to come in and invest or bring, you know, support you
right
with all their heart and all their might, what they have to put you up there, I think it's okay. But it's human behavior. It's about, it's all from leaders.
Okay, so it's from leaders.
Yeah. if someone is ready to push you, I think it's
push.
Around you, you are famous now.
Yeah.
You are.
Yeah.
How would you prevent the fame from stopping you?
Yeah.
From preventing you from getting to where Sak is?
How would I prevent the fame?
Exactly.
Okay, I will not let it get into my head. I just go and work, do my thing. I just do what I want, that what pleases me. If you advise me, I just look at you. It's good. If it's good, I take it and move on. So the stardom, the fame is not in my head. It hasn't got into my head. So.
But what about it is dangerous? Being famous, what about being famous is dangerous? I mean,
for you, well,
you can't do certain things. You say, you maybe what person? Hey, Charlie boy, it's a pie and quiet, but won't be because you need to brand them.
You know when you speak to you sound like Sakode.
Okay, that's great. You need to brand the Awal name.
Yeah, Awal name, and you're not supposed to show face anywhere. When you need to keep your brand, you need to create
because you've learned so much about this thing.
I think Sakode has been a good influence on you, I hope that you know you stay too, because he's one guy who's support the name. Sak sells a stadium, can't sell a stadium. I mean, Sak Nation, when he hosts his concert, Rapaholic, I think the one he did recently, the queue was unbelievable, and I saw it on social media and I was stunned. So yeah, I think you have a good mentor, and I hope that you know you stay humble and grounded. But of course, we can't have you leave the studio without doing your thing.
He has a manager.
Yes,
your manager.
Yeah,
you have. How key is he in all that you do?
Yes.
Like you, because you talked about listening to advice when you're told. How key is your manager in everything that you do? Some of you, pardon me, some of musicians are stubborn. Their manager tells not to do A and they will
We're
do it.
Famous.
I hope you're not doing C.
Yeah, because I think your as an artist, your behavior will lead you to what you want to get.
Okay.
If you want to get up there, and your management is talking to you, and you think it's the right way, and you are avoiding them, I think then you are not ready to go to where you want to go. So if you really need that platform up there, I think you should listen to your management, you know, follow whatever, because they know what you want. I know you know what you want, but they know what you really want.
Okay.
Yeah, so You need to listen to your management.
I'm in awe, and I'm so proud of you, because I remember him so well, right? Very talented, but yet underrated in terms of the brand. But I think you've polished your brand so well, and that's what school does for you. So great job. You're not done, right? You're still polishing.
Yeah, I'm still polishing.
I like that. I absolutely like that. But you have to wrap for us. Please give us a line so that we can lie.
Okay. Abraboni nye easy. Sibinya bama onu ye bine jano hajun fi. Nyamena dema awo. Into when you be now go see the go so I'm see mobi life debts and bounce near war yen that to be now account my three money amre Charlie, to be frank, if it's an uncle pumping a baby your chance, give it to those who are wailing, give it to the people on the street and begging, those who automatically lacking and uncle pond dying to moon shedding. Yes, again, I'm going to be to the year you will be my punya the amimity. Yes, I'm winning one. You could say if you anyway as you being why in ye it, you know, me the minipe the amenance and make it in a boy for the yama Jesus Christo. New town for what should be animated my for honum still moon to me chilling me foku, choma minuku, and I'm honum kuna.
That's a great while. Okay.
Because he's really touching on social issues, being generous to the people who are really in need. Just a quick one.
Yeah.
There you go.
The inspiration behind this one, you know, when you're out there, you see a lot of people struggling. You know, when you walk the roadside, you see people like, you see yourself, you say, hey, Charlie, make crap on me, my friend said, my brother will be. And you, can I just say something? So that's the way it is.
Okay.
So I sat down, drew an inspiration, tapped deep into the soul, and did.
Okay, so tell your fans what you expect from you on May 1, or in the final of Talented Kids.
May 2.
Viewers, sorry.
Second May.
That's the day. The final, grand finale there, and expect him there. Tell your fans what exactly to expect from you. I'm sure you're coming with a big bang.
I'm coming. Mm. I'm coming. You know, I'm coming. Maybe me feel what you say. Inti, then I'm here now. Mhm. We be other than. And it's 6 years now. So, and I've not lost form.
Yeah.
I've gained form.
Yeah.
So come and watch me perform live with my brothers.
Okay, that will take us to a break here. Awal, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're doing amazing. And join them, him and the rest of the talented crew. We will be there. All right, so May 2nd and just to share the
May 2nd.